get down. Get down. You know how I turn up. Turn up. You know how I get down. Get down. You know how I turn up. Turn up. You know how I get down. Get down. You know how I turn up. Turn up. You know how I get down. Get down. Dodio, so the straight shooter. From the guard and I'm dumping out the gray. From the rooter to the tutor. Chiefing on that motherfucking super. Super. Cuff your girl, you can lose her. Yeah. If it's me she choose, I can use her. On the blade, no computer. Nope. If my count ain't right, I'm a booter.
What the fuck,
I go hard, nothing short of that. Every team I'm on, I'm the quarterback. Gardena, yeah, you heard of that. Rep the whole city, watch me murder rap. Slap fire out you whack niggas. You ain't noticed, talent's what you lack, nigga. Spin lies, no facts, nigga. Pad out and feature on your track, nigga. You know how I turn up. Turn up. You know how I get down. Get down. You know how I turn up. Turn up. You know how I get down. Get down. You know how I turn up. Turn up. You know how I get down. Get down. You know how I turn up. Turn up. You know how I get down. Get down. So how you wanna handle that? Spit fire like a dragon, you candle wax. Flip-flop sandals black. The West Side hip-hop vandals back. About to crack like the 80s. In the VIP with all ladies. Cuz O's to the rally.
What up, cuz?
Chrome 24s on Pirellis. My Chevy on stupid. I know I'm the shit. Pollution. You know I'm the solution. Westbound institution. I support prostitution. Motherfuck the Constitution. I gotta win, it's no losing.
No losing.
Better grab your bitch cause she choosing. You know how I turn up. Turn up. You know how I get down. Get down. You know how I turn up. Turn up. You know how I get down. Get down. You know how I turn up. Turn up. You know how I get down. Get down. You know how I turn up. Turn up. You know how I get down. Get down. You know how I turn up.
Turn up.
You know I get down.
Get down.
You know I turn up.
Turn up.
You know I get down.
Get down.
You know I turn up.
Turn up.
You know I get down.
Get down.
You know I turn up.
Turn up.
You know I get down.
Get down.
You know I turn up.
Turn up.
You know I get down.
Get down.
You know I turn up.
Turn up.
You know I get down.
Get down.
You know I turn up.
Turn up.
You know how I get down.
Get down.
You know how I turn up.
Turn up.
You know how I get down.
Get down.
Out the gray, from the rooter to the tutor, chiefing on that motherfucking super, super, cuff your girl, you can lose her, if it's me she choose, I can use her, on the blade, no computer, if my count ain't right, I'm a booter, I go hard, nothing short of that, every team I'm on, I'm the quarterback, Gardena, yeah, you heard of that. Rep the whole city, watch me murder rap. Slap fire out you whack niggas. You ain't noticed, talent's what you lack, nigga. Spin lies, no facts, nigga. Pad out and feature on your...
Yo, pop my collar, this is volume 10, sitting here chilling at the B-side show. I don't know what y'all doing, but y'all better hit up my motherfucking show at the airliner every second Saturday of the month. You better know it. Better know it.
We're back, man.
We're live. It's the B-side show. Hey, you can tell we're live because you can see people floating around and shit.
Go ahead.
Hey, we got our next guest at the building, man. We'll run it down the line, but this is Pharaoh's Inc. representing right here.
Yeah.
Go ahead and run it down the line. Introduce yourselves, man.
Go ahead.
My name is Robert Galvan from Pharaoh's Inc., Santa Ana. I specialize in black and gray, and it's good to check us out on Pharaoh's Inc. and Pharaoh's Daddy.
Right on.
My name is Graphic. I'm an apprentice under Robert Galvan.
That's right.
What's going on, man? My name is Oscar. I'm an artist at Pharaoh's Inc.
Nice. My name is Jessica Galvan, and I'm an apprentice at Pharaoh's Inc.
Yo, what's up? It's Bates. You can find me at Bates Tattoos. I'm an artist at Pharaoh's Inc. Check us out at Pharaoh's Inc. too.
That's right, man.
Yo, I'm Manny, apprentice under Rob Galvan.
He's lying. That's not right. You know what? Honestly, I'm very proud because you guys know how I geek out every time someone comes through from the OC. This is very special and dear to me because these are actually a lot of my friends from high school.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So I'm very happy to, like, be able to, you know, bring them along and help them out and, you know, give them a platform like the B-side.
And, yeah, you know, right, they're like fam now, too, because I know they already inked up Gene, and then I'm going soon. Bates.
And cocaine.
Bates
cocaine
got me.
Too.
Oh, cocaine right here live on the show.
Yeah, I saw that session.
You did that, right? Yeah.
Yeah, that was him.
He gave him the hand shot right there, man. Dirty OGs, man. That live right here on the B-side show, though, man. So it's like fam already. Yeah. But talk about it, man. You guys got a lot of coming up. You guys are going around and making your rounds and all that, letting it be known, right?
Yeah, yeah, for sure. This Thursday, we're going out to Laredo, Texas. We're doing a convention from the 3rd to the 6th, I believe. Pretty much booked up for the whole weekend already. So it seems pretty good right now. You know, I haven't even been there yet and booked up, so...
Is that your first time over there?
Laredo, yeah. First time, never been there before. Social media, man, saves lives.
Are you the only one going?
Right now, it's just me and Oscar. Oscar's tattoos.
Okay.
We're going right now, so.
That's right, man. Getting the Pharaoh's Inc. name out there wherever it can. You know what I'm saying?
They're going international. They just got back not that long ago from Bogota. They're in Colombia.
These guys were in Colombia. I didn't get a chance, but yeah.
Talk about that. How was that trip, man?
It was a badass trip, man. Crazy experience. Totally something totally different, you know?
And were the heads all waiting for you? Got, like, anxious to get their tattoos over there, man?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Everybody, yeah. We had a lot of work, you know. It was a really good trip.
Is the culture, I mean, because I don't get to travel too much, so I live through the people that come on our show. Like, that's how I travel. I just ask them, how was it? Hey, no, but when you went, is there a big time, tattoo culture out there as well?
Oh, yeah, big time. I was really surprised. It was really big out there. Everybody has tattoos over there right now.
Oh, okay.
Did you guys kick it with Pablo Escobar? Just kidding.
Yeah, it'd be funny. Yeah, in his room. I was saying, oh, that's all bad, man. I'm not even gonna go there. Hey, but okay. So speaking of what you got, we talked a little bit about what you guys specialize in, man. Let me ask you guys that are interning or apprenticeship or whatever. What kind of artwork are you aiming toward? Is your specialty in tatting?
I've always been inspired by people like cartoon, so okay. I think doing a lot of black and gray
black
style.
And gray. Yeah.
All right. I'm curious if there was any. I have to ask. Is there any tattoo that you guys said no? I can't do that. I'm sorry. No.
I don't think so.
Yeah. So anything? Okay, that's good. I saw a show. What was it? Man, was it the Kat Von D show? This was years ago, and this chick wanted it. She swore she saw her mother on a piece of pizza. No, but she got it tattooed right here on her neck. Yeah, it's because she swears she saw a picture of her mother in this piece of pizza, and she got it tattooed on her. Do you remember that?
Yeah, I know.
You saw that one?
And Kat said, you know, I almost didn't do it, but she's like, she was paying me a lot of money, so yeah.
Hey, so how about you? What style? What's yours?
I also like black and gray. You know, like I'm apprenticing under him, so I mean, I'm very inspired by his work and everybody here too. Everybody's helped us out a lot, especially us being graphic. Rob brought us in, and everybody else kind of took us in, just like that.
That's good, because you guys, I can tell, like are kind of like a fam, like how we are on the B-side show. Like we don't see each other. Most of us don't see each other every day or whatever. Yeah. But when we work. It's like fam. You know what I'm saying? And I could tell that you guys are like that as well.
Yeah.
So hey, you know, myself in particular, I saw the show Ink Master, right? Yeah. And like I'm more. My particular preference in tats, is black and gray, but I've been like seeing a lot of like different styles through these shows because tattooing is getting more, I guess, well-rounded international, where people are like getting more into it. And the girl that, what's her name, man? I can't remember. She was like one of the runners up. I think they call it new school or whatever. Her style is like with characters, like cartoons. But shit is crazy. So I'm getting exposed to new styles as well. So do you guys at the shop, do you guys get any, outrageous, like, ideas that you guys got to put together yourself? I mean, because you guys are...
Most of the time we try to do original stuff, so Photoshop is basically our savior. We can come up with so much crazy stuff and original as well, too, so... Definitely.
So Photoshop is how you kind of customize it to what, like...
Majority of the time, that's how these days is working. Yeah, but we try to draw as well, just to keep up with the work, you know, so...
Yeah, that's another question I have. If somebody gives you, you know, they say, this is what I want, but I don't know how to... Is that annoying? Like, but I don't know what I want, but this is my idea. Do you guys have to come up with your own... creative idea, both.
I think both client and artist
have to
communicate. Because I can come up with something and at the end of the day you might not
like
it.
It's on you forever.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Oh, cool.
Hey, I wish it would have worked out. Like, we were all busy today, but, like, it was so hectic today, but I actually wanted to get, I was going to get my tab before the show started, man. I'm ready for my shit. I ain't scared. Hey, but
he's going to get B-side to across his neck.
Yeah, yeah, on my forehead. Hey, Bates was almost as tall as Meta, though, man. You were right there with her.
You know, I was going to say, usually Rabbit's the tallest one in here. Yeah, and looking at Rabbit beside Meta, I was like, damn, Rabbit, it's taking a
I was up to his hip. I was up to his hip, I think. Hey, so let them know where the shop's at and all that stuff and how they can go about getting appointments and all that stuff, man.
It's the address is 13912 Ponderosa Street in Santa Ana.
Do you guys have any hashtags they can find you?
Yeah, Pharaoh Zinc. Yeah, we always hashtag Pharaoh Zinc. And we take walk-ins too. There's, you know, we definitely wonder because a lot of the guys will come up with the stuff right there on the spot. You know, you could just go Pharaoh.inc or Instagram through Pharaoh.inc too on Instagram.
Hey, you know what? I kind of want to hear what Manny has to say.
Yeah, man.
I haven't heard from this guy yet.
Well,
so,
make sure you talk about the barbershop.
Hey,
we got
Manny,
a barbershop.
Is this our
expanding
chance? Let's hear, man.
Yeah. And I'm taking off questions right now. Let me have them.
Anybody have a question for Manny? Hit us up on the chat room, man. What's up, Manny? Let them know what the business is.
Well, the business, we got a barbershop located in downtown Santa Ana where we both collab together. So, first Saturday of the month, they host an art walk. So what we're trying to do is kind of have like a little seminar, life tattoo. People can come in and ask questions about certain styles or, you know, different ideas or any what they want to progress in their, you know, tatting art, because we're not just limited to tattooing. A lot of these guys are mirrorless, you know, pencil drawers. They can work with many different types of art. So, you know, downtown Santa Ana, art walk, look it up. Pharaoh Zinc will be associated with the main cave.
That's right, man. Cave. There, I had to get my fix of Manny in. Hey, no,
you
but
can get a haircut while you get tatted up.
Get a haircut, get tatted, all that stuff. Hey, you know what though? I really love looking at, you know, beautiful pictures, paintings, artwork. But the thing is, like, I never had that skill. You know what I'm saying? So I don't know if I appreciate it more, I guess, because the fact that, like, I never, like, my writing's sloppy. You know what I'm saying? So when I see people and they're able not only draw something or write something really nice, but to transfer it onto somebody's skin,
right,
like, that shit is dope as hell right there.
Yeah,
man,
you know what? And my cousin, his penmanship is flawless. I mean, it's beautiful. And so he wanted to get into tattooing. So my friend gave him a pig's ear, right? Is that what you practice? And he could not. He said, wow, it takes a totally different skill to tattoo than use a pencil or a pen, right? Yeah, it's a different skill. So.
And is that mostly because the canvas is actually moving, right? Like, it's not a fucking...
It's not just flat, you know, it's just body parts, so you got to work with that.
Yeah.
Or a fucking elbow bone or something.
Yeah, or they say it was a pig's ear because they said it's the closest to human skin.
And we're so surprised every time somebody does a tattoo. We're always like, damn, that shit looks fucking tight. Even though we all are artists, you know what I mean? Right. Like, even when we're getting
you
done,
appreciate
like, oh,
other work.
Yeah, exactly.
So let me ask you this, though, as far, I mean, you guys been doing your thing for a minute and stuff, but any artists out there, not just tattoo-wise, but that have inspired you to draw or to tattoo or anything like that?
OG Abel.
Yeah, OG Abel.
Abel?
Yeah, OG.
No, I've heard that from a few cats.
Jesus Helguera, Mexican painter. He does a lot of great, good stuff. Aztec, Revolution stuff. You know, all that art, Mexican, you know, heritage stuff. So
that's dope, though. That's dope to hear. How about you, Manny?
Well, I follow a lot of comic book artists like Alex Ross, you know, Jim Lee, you know, Snyder. A little old school like that.
Hey, a lot of the crew here fucks with comic books heavy. So that's funny you said that, man. How about you, Doug? You know, inspirations or whatever, man.
Yeah, well, OG Abel.
Oh, OG
my favorite,
Abel.
Cartoon's good too. I really like his style.
Who didn't get to answer? We'll pass the mics back, man.
OG Abel, man. OG Abel has great art. Yeah, same thing.
Oh, okay.
Cartoon, Kat Von D. I mean, everybody, really. You can learn something from everybody, so.
Everyone at Pharaoh's, for sure. Those are the ones that I'm like, legit.
That's a good apprentice right there.
I'm legit
there.
Blown
yes.
away.
Everyone
no,
at Pharaoh's.
Not just that, like, I'm legit blown away. They're
girl.
All different, too. They're all different, so yeah. You learn so much, and I didn't think I was going to, like pick up things like that, but because they help me so much, and they're all kind of different styles. Some of them are really good at their, like, lettering. Other ones are, like, specialized in color. Others specialize in black and gray, realistic. Others are traditional. They kill it. So,
as an apprentice,
yeah.
How do you? So you're basically at the shop, and yeah. you follow. You just watch them and
yeah, you watch them. They'll help you out with, like, you know, learning how to stencil and then how to, like, put something together, how to talk to their clients, how to do everything like that.
Nice.
So from, like, A to B, how to set up, how to be, you know, sterile, make sure everything's sterilized, all that stuff, like everything. So
yep.
And she's the only girl. Yeah. Hola.
No,
that's really we got Koopa over there.
Oh,
Koopa.
Damn.
There we go.
He didn't tell me that. He didn't tell me that.
She's like recording.
Wait, oh, come yeah? here. Come
oh,
in.
Oh, all right.
She's filming.
No, it's okay. Come in.
Wait, get in real quick.
Yeah, man.
I know she's on filming duty.
This is Koopa.
It's part of the... This is Koopa.
Here, introduce yourself.
Hey, you got down right here. We got.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, there it is right there.
Insane. She's
that's
so
dope.
Good.
Wow.
So good.
So how long you've been working on ink?
8 years.
8 years?
Nice.
All right, cool, man. So are you happy to be part of the Pharaoh's team?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Very talented.
Hey, thanks for coming through, though, man. I can already see what you
Thank
did
you.
On his arm, right? And obviously, for Bates to give you, you know, his forearm, he trusts you.
Yeah,
like,
he trusts
for real.
You.
That's a big deal. Hey, so run it down the line again. We're going to let everybody know where they can get at you guys, but also where you guys are heading out to again one more time. Let everybody know.
All right, man. You can follow me on Instagram, Oscar M Tattoos, Facebook, Oscar Macias. And again, we're going to go to Laredo, Texas. Going to be out there February 3, 4, and 5.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Is that a convention, by the way?
Yes.
Okay.
Yo, you guys can follow me at Bates Tattoos. Also, check out Pharaoh's Ink, pharaohsink.com. We'll be out in Laredo, 3rd to the 6th. After that, we'll be at Mississippi, March 24th, I believe, 25th and 26th, by Loxing. Other than that,
that's right. They're making their rounds, man.
Yeah, just make sure to follow us on Instagram, pharaohs.ink. Make sure to follow us at The Main Cave 2017. And here's Big Rob.
Oh, it's The Main Cave, not The Man Cave? Oh, The Main Cave.
The Main Cave.
You can check out some of my work on Instagram on Rob_GalvanTattoos. And you can follow us, find all of us at Pharaoh's Ink. Everybody has a little bit of work up there already.
You did the one on Gene.
Yeah,
Big
I did
Gene
that one
right
on
here.
Gene, yeah.
Yeah, Big Gene and Cocaine got tatted live right here the last time these guys were through, man. So that was dope. Hey, thank you. Did anybody else get everybody get their go ahead and let them know where they could get at you.
I'm on Instagram at Art by Graphic, GRAFIK, and Snapchat too.
That's right, man.
You can find me on Instagram, Koopa Deuce.
Koopa Deuce?
Koopa Deuce.
C or a K?
Duke.
K.
K.
Koopa Deuce.
Oh, Koopa Deuce. My Thank bad.
My name is JetsKitty91, but you can find us all on The Pharaoh's Ink.
Okay. The Pharaoh's Ink family is in the building,
yeah.
man. And you know what? Like, they're on their show tonight, but this ain't the last. We all kick it because we're going to go get some more work. We're doing all kinds of stuff. We'll be collabing. You guys stay tuned for more collabs coming your way with Pharaoh's Ink and the B-Side show, man. That's how it goes,
The
man.
Official B-Side tattoo shop.
Oh, yeah. You know how we're doing it. You'll see me and Gene over there when we'll get it on our Snapchat and all that stuff, man. So, hey, thank you guys for coming through. It was another real dope show. I want to thank the whole team.
Thank you for having us.
Okay. Shay's yelling at me over
there. We got a video coming up.
We're going to play this video right here. Mighty Tribe, One Night in Japan. We'll be right back after this B-Side show.
B-Side, what happened in Japan?
Flat lights, pink crowd. eternity, cosmic gods, and be like God, oh no, wow. Melody, apparently, I throw the crown inside a sunken hole, wow. Most of the attention seeks a meet and greet to leave this microphone like, not throwing at it, put him in your throat like you was an addict. Coming when the moonlight shining at him, leave it on the streets for you wasn't ready. I knock him down like dominoes, you could be a king or die alone. I'm pulling strings like a puppeteer, it's a new year in Tokyo.
They start believing when you can't say the competition right. They start misleading when you fell into repetition right. Tainted my freedom is leading me into a better life. So get my 40 and let's party, there's no end in nine. Up top I'm a savage hoe, so sick I'm on a head of dub.
Hip hop, hip hop.
Down, down in a clap, go rock crowds like a talent show. Don't need any pot of gold, don't need anyone, I'm thrown.
Bitch, please.
Proceed, let the rocks know I'm the goat when I connect flows. Outcast since high school, I swear to God, bumping B.O.P. Crack class 2011, got my city dripping with sick MCs. Hopping out of that spaceship, I remain broke but with a scheme. Bump rapping, it changed my life, so yeah, fucking right, I'ma live the dream. J-Town,
J-Town, J-Town, J-Town.
Back, man. Hey, another dope show, man. Thank everybody for coming through. Pharaoh Zing, Taz Zavala, and Mr. Metal World Peace from the Lakers, man. Ron
and
Artest,
DJ
man.
Choice One.
And Choice One. Hey, thank you for coming through again, fam. And we just did. We're going to be previewing to you guys soon our DJ team, man. We got a photo shoot that we just got off, and we'll be promoing to you guys real soon.
We also got a photo shoot with all of the female hosts. And
oh, yeah.
Rabbit.
That's going to be
some
crazy
that.
Shit. That's going to be
We're
crazy.
Doing a 70s theme, right?
Yeah. The new promo is going to be off the hook. You guys just keep riding with us. You're going to see how we move, man. We're doing it. We definitely, the team is strong right now, so we want to keep that momentum going. Real quick, 130 Shoppers Lane in Covina. Come down to the B-side shop. We got a lot of different independent brands in here. Hobos, Three Dreams. Now Panda's friend is in here. Metal World Pieces brand, our brand as well. Also on the channel, B-side channel, our website, we do, you guys could do ads if you guys want to promote a new video, a new album, your tattoo shop, whatever it is, get up on our site, man, and get that. And then our YouTube channel, make sure you guys subscribe, B-side show, yeah. Man. That's what it is. Hey, and let them know, Crystal, what you've been up to, too. Let them know where they can find you.
You know, I've been DJing, you know, so DJing, raising a little puppy. I just got this new gig at Pechanga Casino at the Eagle's Nest, the club on top of the hotel. So that's cool. That's a new gig I got. And I'm recording my third album with Lightning Cloud, Red Cloud, shout out.
What up, Red Cloud?
Yeah. So stay tuned for that. That's going to be dope. I'm excited about that album. It's all straight from the heart, you know?
Yeah,
getting real with it.
As it should be, man. Make sure you guys stay tuned for that, and we'll let you guys know as it comes closer. Hey, DJ Choice, one on the ones and twos, man. What up with you, Choice? Hey, yeah, you got a mic
for
right there,
For those of you
homes.
Guys who don't know, Choice One, he spins for K-Day, 93.5.
K-Day.
So.
And he's also one of the hosts on Feed Me Radio.
Feed Me, homie.
Yeah. That's kind of
shout
feed
out,
me.
Shout out Lucy, Booty Brown, the whole Far Side team over there. I didn't forget about y'all.
Far Side.
I'm still here.
Far Side TV. What's the site you guys are on, too, on Feed Me Radio? Let them know.
Well, farsidetv.com. Yeah, there
you go. And that's with Lucy, right?
Yeah, with Lucy.
Yeah, shout out to Lucy. I love that girl.
And is that every other week or every week?
No, that's every Thursday.
Every Thursday. Make sure you guys check that out. Choice One is the co-host with Miss Lucy, man. So
they let me talk on that show.
I know. Well, you I was gonna say you get to take a break from DJing on that show.
Nah, this season it was kind of her choice, so we're just bringing in a guest DJ. But I mean, it's beneficial to me. It's giving me practice, you know.
Yeah.
Interview and research artists before they come in, you know.
Cool.
It's only helping me.
It's different, huh?
You see, I'm talking on the mic. I didn't used to do this back in the day.
Oh, yeah. DJ Choice, what, man? You guys already know, man. Hey, and where can they catch you, man? What you got coming up? Let them know and all your Instagram, all that shit.
I finally have a break. My February is looking real empty, and I'm not complaining right now.
Yeah. Sometimes you need to rest.
Yeah, this is like my first weekend off, honestly, since probably like September.
Yeah. And you know, it's called incubation time. Sometimes you need to just chill
looking,
with yourself.
Yeah, I'm definitely looking forward to some sleep.
Yeah.
Well, you know what? I'm lying because I just got hit up for a gig Saturday, so I'm lying.
This Saturday?
Yeah, I can't turn no money down.
Okay, so where is it? Let them know.
I don't know. The homie Hoser. Shout out Hoser.
Hoser?
We're gonna, yeah. We're
I
gonna,
grew up with Hoser. We're I gonna, went to high school with Hoser.
We're going
to
give you the info in a
He said I'm going to book you. I don't know where, but whatever.
Hey, I don't know but who all Crystal grew up with, but I remember it was funny. We posted something, and all these people started responding like, oh, I know her. I gave her my pet turtle in junior high. That shit was funny as hell. I'm like, what the fuck? So Crystal got pet turtles.
Thanks
and stuff.
For my pet turtle.
But being in L.A., how you know which Hoser I'm talking about?
There's only one Hoser.
Oh, okay.
What up, Hoser? Hey, you guys.
And they don't call him Hoser for nothing. Let's put it that
check
way.
Check us out every Monday night on the BsideShow.net, 9 p.m. or somewhere in that vicinity, because we're hip hop. You know how it is, man. But live is guests every week. You can see as we did today. Thank you guys for all the support out there. We appreciate that shit. And shouts to the whole team, man. We'll see you guys next week. It's the B-Side.
We
out.
Love you.
And the wingman, Trinidad Loco. Where'd he go? We could smoke now, Trini.